You've all heard it a million times. Once you cross the edge of a black hole, its event horizon, you're finished, you're doomed, you can't escape. But why is that? I mean, sure, black holes can exert a powerful gravitational grip, but why can't you just strap on a super strong rocket and blast your way out? Well, you can't, and this is the first of three short videos in which I'll give you some mind-bending explanations of why no conceivable technology will ever change the conclusion that crossing a black hole's event horizon is a one-way journey. All right, here's one particularly evocative way to think about it. Intuitively, most of us still think of space as a kind of container, an arena within which the events of the universe take place. But over 100 years ago, Einstein showed that space and time, too, they are active participants in the unfolding of the cosmos. Space in particular can stretch as in the expansion of the universe, and it can also vibrate, it can oscillate as in gravitational waves. What's less familiar is that space can also flow, kind of like the flow of water heading downstream in a river. Now, you can make this all mathematically precise, which for fun I'll do at the very end, but the relevance of the flow of space for black holes is this. You can think of a black hole like a cosmic waterfall. Now, in an earthly waterfall, water flows over a cliff's edge, while in a black hole, space flows over the black hole's edge, its event horizon. So imagine you're in a kayak near an ordinary waterfall. If you can paddle faster than the flow of the water, you'll be fine, right? You can paddle your way out. But if the current is faster than you can paddle, you're in trouble. The flowing water will draw you closer and closer to the cliff, and finally, over the edge you'll go. A similar story plays out near a black hole. When you're outside the black hole, the flow of space toward the black hole is less than the speed of light, so in principle, with sufficiently powerful engines, you can't escape. But as you get closer to the event horizon, the speed of flowing space increases. And at the event horizon itself, space flows over the edge at the speed of light. And since nothing can travel faster than the speed of light, there's no way you can possibly escape. I don't care how powerful your rocket engines are. With space flowing at the speed of light, there simply is no way to overcome the downstream motion. And so once you reach the black hole's edge, you are doomed. And that's why a black hole is a cosmic waterfall, or perhaps I should say a spacefall, from which there is no return. Okay, I promised a moment on the mathematics. Here it is. This is the usual Schwarzschild metric for a black hole, and here is a clever rewriting of that metric in so-called Panleve coordinates, which have the virtue that there's no coordinate singularity at the event horizon. Rewriting this again so that capital T is the proper time, we have this equation here where we can see space being dragged along by this term right over here, where we have the square root of 2m over r, which when r equals 2m, namely when we are located at the black hole's event horizon, the speed of flowing space is equal to c, the speed of light. So thinking of space as a river, objects can move through the river, but the rushing water carries them along with its own additional speed. And at the black hole's event horizon, this river of space is rushing inward at the speed of light, so nothing can make progress away from the black hole. Everything is pulled in. Okay, that's it. That's one way of understanding why once you cross the event horizon, there is no way to escape a black hole. And in the following two videos, I'm gonna give you yet other ways to reach the very same conclusion, that crossing the event horizon of a black hole is always a one-way journey.